In the WhenToWork system, the jobs that your employees perform are called positions. If you go to Employees Positions Grid, you'll see a complete list of the positions in your account across the top, with each employee checked off as able to work certain ones. If an employee is not checked off for a position, then they can't work shifts for that position. You can edit directly on this grid. You can check off more positions for an employee to work. They're highlighted in orange until they've been saved. Click the Save Changes button when done. You'll find more advanced optional position settings if you click the pencil icon beside your employees' names. You can edit three different kinds of position settings. First, position preferences. If you click on any position once, it will turn green. This means that you prefer that position for that employee. Whenever you have inventory shifts available, you prefer that employee be assigned. This allows autofill to take into account their position preferences. If you click again, it'll turn pink. That means that you dislike the employee working this kind of shift. They're available if you don't have anyone else, but you would prefer they not be assigned to that position. Click again, and it goes back to no preference. You can set a default pay rate if your employee is paid the same, no matter what position they're working. But if they get paid differently for doing different jobs, you can set pay rates per position. Alert dates are for things like certifications. If your employee has a certification with a particular expiration date, you can enter that as an alert date, and WhenToWork will help you keep track of the dates. If scheduled past that date, we will highlight that in red so that you are aware they are beyond that alert date. Autofill can still assign them, and you can choose to manually assign them past this date, but you will be alerted on the schedule if it happens. You can update their alert dates right here. When you're ready, click Save. You can see the position preferences you've set highlighted on the grid. Positions highlighted in green are set to Preferred, and positions highlighted in pink are set to Dislike. To edit the name of any position, click on the top pencil icon and simply change the name and click OK. Keep in mind that you're not only changing the name for that position on future shifts, but also for all past shifts associated with that position. So if you're making a big change, you might want to go ahead and create a new position instead. If you'd like to add or edit positions, click on Add Edit Positions, and you can create a new position. Simply enter the name and click Add, and you'll see it show up on your list of positions. If you click Edit Delete, you can edit position names just as we did on the other screen. Simply make your edit and click OK. You can also edit the sort order of your positions. If you'd like them to sort alphabetically, simply click the default Sort Alphabetically link. But if you'd like to customize your sort order, for instance, if you want to put your cashiers together or your managers at the bottom, you can simply drag the positions into the order you like and click Save. This will save your new sort order. While it's not normally recommended, it is possible to delete a position. If you go to the Delete tab, you'll see that some positions have a checkbox under Delete. These positions do not have any future shifts on your schedule. If a position has future shifts, it cannot be deleted. You would have to search those future shifts and then delete them or edit them to another position and then come back to delete that position. It's really only appropriate to delete a position if it's never had any shifts. Because every shift in our system has to be associated with a position. And if you delete a position, you're deleting it for all past and future schedules, which means that any past shifts associated with that position will no longer exist. On any schedule view or report that lists by position, you won't be able to see that position, so any shifts for that position will not show up. For this reason, we discourage deleting positions, and only the main manager has the authority to do it. If you do want to delete a position, simply click Delete, and then choose Delete Selected. This will take the position out of all schedules, past and future. Note that we do offer a list of recently deleted positions. You can click on any recently deleted position to restore the name. After a while, those deleted positions will age off the list and it will not be possible to restore them. If you'd like to be able to group certain positions together, in the Positions dropdown, choose Select, Group Positions. Let's say you wanted to see all of your cashier shifts together. You could check off all of the cashier positions and then name the group Cashiers and click Save. Now your view is filtered to just those cashier positions you set into the group. This comes in very handy when you go to your schedules. If you have a manager who schedules only cashiers, now they can view the schedule with only the cashiers. They can filter the schedule to the cashier group, to look at the cashier shifts, or even to import only cashier shifts, or autofill only cashier shifts, or even publish only cashier shifts. Of course, you can still select to filter just to a particular type of cashier position. Or you can select all positions and view the entire schedule together. Under Settings, we have some global employee permissions related to positions. You can allow employees to set their own preferences for positions, that is, the prefer and dislike setting, which can be used when autofilling. You could also allow the employees to see the position groups filter on their everyone's schedule view. Then, whenever employees are looking at their schedules, whether they're using a computer or the app, they'll be able to filter to the customized groups that you've created, like cashiers.